School just started. Already a high school student brought two guns, not one, to school. And yep, it actually discharged. It fired inside of the school. Let me take you to a place called Henry County, Georgia. The Henry County School District said the police were called to the school Wednesday morning after reports of what sounded like gunshots inside of the school. Now, you have to already imagine. That means that multiple individuals in the school called the police. And when they called 911, they said, listen, we just heard gunshots inside of this school. So everything was shut down immediately. There's an adjacent elementary school across the street from this high school. So they shut down the high school. They also did a complete lockdown of the elementary school. Everybody's panicking, everybody's afraid. There's more. School officer said they quickly reacted to put the school on a hard lockdown. And their investigation led them to a student who had the guns, plural, in a backpack. Police said one of the guns went off when the student dropped the bag, which also means the gun was not on safety. District officials say the gun discharged from inside the backpack when they set it on the ground in the school gym. I have some questions here. First of all, school just started. You already have a student bringing two guns to school. Now, there are a couple of reasons, maybe three, why you would do this. Number one, to show it off. Number two, to sell it, or to sell at least one, maybe both. Number three, to do some damage, to do some harm. Now, the protocols of this school did not work. They do have a protocol, if you know something, say something. They do have a protocol to check for suspicious activity. They do not have any metal detector systems, et cetera, in this school system. This was exposed because of a mistake. We cannot forget that. Their security protocols did not help. Their security protocols did not stop this from happening. And yes, obviously somebody could have been shot and somebody could be dead right now. And the only reason the school system is aware that a kid had two guns in a book bag is because that kid made a mistake, dropped the book bag, and a firearm discharged. There's more. Okay, so the school system says the very quick response of our law enforcement partners resulted in the lockdowns at McDonough High School and adjacent McDonough Middle School being lifted in order for school operations to proceed as normal. So they were lifted pretty quickly once they recognized who actually did it. Let's go back to the reality of our country. You cannot talk about incidents like this in a silo and say this is separate than anything else that's happening in America. We have a gun culture. We talked about this up and down, right? Where did the kid get access to a gun, let alone two? Was there an adult that noticed you have two guns missing in your household? Or maybe you have so many guns at home that you don't see them as missing guns. Or perhaps even worse, you allow this minor to possess firearms and you have no issue with it whatsoever. Whatever it is, it connects back to a gun culture in this country. And until we address the culture of the thing, the policy of the thing can continue to change while the culture remains the same, and your conclusion will be the same as well. Ben, thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, really, the gun policy in the United States is just so ridiculous. Because it's like, imagine there's somebody in town that just runs around like dumping buckets of rats all over town. And the policy from the government was not to do anything about the guy putting rats everywhere, but is just to like, well, maybe we'll put some rat traps here, maybe we'll, you know, put some bait here. And like, yeah, sure, that might slightly reduce like the rat problem in your city a little bit, but maybe address the people who are like dumping rats everywhere. I don't know. And like, that's what it is with guns, because how does a child get access to a gun? Only in a world where you have people that are deeply irresponsible, where people feel like guns are just toys, these casual things to be thrown around, will you have children having access to firearms like this? Because this is not a thing that happens in other countries, believe it or not. You know, even police officers in other countries very often will have to call into their office before they even get their firearm from their trunk. And here in the United States, like literally children kill themselves, their friends, their family members with guns by accident all the time. And it's just really, really heartbreaking and infuriating to see this.
We are glad that no child was hurt, no faculty member or staff member was injured or killed out of this incident. But let's talk about Georgia law just for a minute. And I've had Ted Terry on this show, who's a progressive, used to be the mayor of a place called Clarkston, Georgia, is now a county commissioner for DeKalb County in Metro Atlanta. Ted Terry tried to get a new civil law passed that would create a significant punishment civilly, monetarily, for parents who did not secure their weapons and children got access to them. Well, lo and behold, there's a law in Georgia that prohibits local jurisdictions from passing any laws related to guns. How insane is that? While the party, the Republican Party, they promote an ideology that says, we believe in local control. As soon as locals try to control their destiny as it relates to gun policy, they create a state law prohibiting them from doing so. Just a note. All right.